Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. In the last class, we are discussing KSET NEET JEE model MCQs from the topic amino acids and proteins. So here we are going to continue the session. Yes, on the screen, you are seeing question number 6. Once read the question number 6. From your material, volume number 4, page number 120. Chapter is biomolecules, objective exercise 2, question number 6. Yes, read the question number 6. Which of the following Fisher projection formulae represents capital R alanine? Here capital R. This is indicating relative configurations, RS configurations. In the first phase, also you studied about RS configurations. So here first we have to know what is an alanine. Yes, in the last video we discussed glycine and alanine. Yes, on the board I am going to write what is an alanine. Yes, alanine, question number 6. R alanine. I am taking alanine first. I am not saying whether it is R or S. Simply I am going to take the alanine by taking across. At the top, COOH group. At the left side, NH2 group. At the bottom, hydrogen. And here, residual group. Residual group is replaced. R group, residual group is replaced with CH3. Then this is called as alanine. And my dear students, all of you know the cross point, the cross junction point is indicating a carbon. Now this carbon is having 4 different groups. Carboxylic acid group, amine group, hydrogen, and CH3 group. So whenever a carbon is having 4 different groups, such carbon is called as chiral carbon. The carbon is called as chiral carbon. So this compound, which is known as containing chiral carbon, the chiral carbon is also called as asymmetric carbon. Chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. This type of compounds can rotate plane polarized light either in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. So simply we can say that alanine is optically active amino acid or alpha amino acid. Please remember this statement. What is the statement? Alanine is containing a chiral carbon. This is the chiral carbon containing 4 different groups. So we can say that the chiral carbon containing a compound or the asymmetrical carbon containing compound generally can rotate the plane polarized light either in the clockwise direction or in the anti-clockwise direction. Hence it is an example of, alanine is an example of optically active alpha amino acid. But here the question asks this, we have to find the R alanine. So then we are going to see the options. What is meant by R alanine? How can we understand R alanine? Yes, on the screen, you are seeing now option number 2. If you see in your material, option number 2. Yes, wait a minute. It is going to share. Yes, if you see the option number 2 in your material, Is it visible to you? Option number 2. Okay, now it is visible to all of you. Okay, right. So option number 2, this is the structure given. Just once observe the structure given. I am indicating the cross point or the junction point, that is the carbon containing 4 different groups. That is carboxylic acid group, amine group, methyl group, and hydrogen. So we can say that alanine is optically active compound. Okay. And in this given structure, you will get a doubt. Sir, here NH2 group is present on the right side. Don't worry. Whatever the structure given, just observe the structure first and try to understand the groups given. Here, RS configuration, capital R, capital S configuration is depending upon atomic ranking method. atomic ranking method. Now coming to the groups. Here I mentioned the NH2 group as Roman number 1, carboxylic acid group as Roman number 2, and methyl group as Roman number 3. On which basis I am writing these Roman numbers? That means this amine group is given as first rank. Carboxylic acid group is given as second rank. Methyl group is given as third rank. On which basis the ranks are given? Based on their atomic numbers. Yes. To this carbon, here directly nitrogen is attached. Here, to the same carbon, here carbon is attached. To this same carbon, here also carbon is attached. To this same carbon, here hydrogen is attached. All of you know the atomic numbers. Hydrogen, helium, lithium, beryllium, boron, carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, fluorine, neon, and so on. Hydrogen atomic number 1, helium atomic number 2, lithium atomic number 3, beryllium atomic number 4, boron atomic number 5, carbon atomic number 6, nitrogen atomic number 7, oxygen atomic number 8, next, fluorine atomic number 9, neon atomic number 10. Yes, coming to the atomic ranking method, this carbon, the central carbon attached with nitrogen atomic number 7, whereas the central carbon attached with carbon atomic number only 6, the central carbon attached with carbon atomic number only 6. And the central carbon attached with hydrogen atomic number is only 1. So which one is having the higher atomic number? Nitrogen is having the higher atomic number. So this NH2 group is considered as the higher ranking group. Higher ranking group, HRG. So this is given as the first preference or first rank. Next, here carbon is there. Here also carbon is there. But after the carbon, here oxygen atoms are there. But here hydrogen atoms are there. So which group is given the more priority? Carboxylic acid group is given as the more priority than methyl group. So carboxylic acid group is given as the second rank. Methyl group is given as the third rank. And finally, hydrogen is given as the fourth rank. Always the hydrogen is given as the least rank. That is the fourth rank. So now if you observe the ranks, rank 1, rank 2, and rank 3. And if you rotate these ranks, what you are going to observe? The rankings are rotated in a counterclockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Then this configuration is called as which type of configuration? It is R configuration, capital R configuration. So if you see the question number 6 in your material, which of the following Fischer projection formula represents R alanine? Yes, if you check the options once, question number 6. Yes, check the option. Yes, option number 2. Important model. RS configurations, very, very important model. In the first PUC also you studied about this one. And in the second PUC, from the chapter haloalkanes and halorines, we studied about optical isomerism. There, we were discussed about DL configurations as well as RS configurations. If you didn't watch those videos, you can go to the playlist haloalkanes and halorines. There you can find the DL configurations as well as RS configurations. Right? Okay, moving to the question number 7. See the question number 7. Read the question number 7. Yes, on the screen you can see now. The number of peptide bonds present in tetrapeptide is. Once again, the number of peptide bonds present in tetrapeptide is. So first of all, we have to know what is meant by a peptide. Just we are discussing about amino acids. So the amino acids, when they are going to undergo polymerization by the removal of small molecules like water molecule, that polymerization process is called as condensation polymerization. So here, alpha amino acids, when they are going to get condensed with each other, the large molecules are going to be formed. They are called as peptides. Peptides. So here we are going to see the peptide formation, how a peptide is going to be formed. Here you can observe the formation of peptides. Yes, I'm going to share to you from your NCERT class 12 chemistry textbook 2020. NCERT chemistry class 12 chemistry textbook year of 2020. On the screen you are seeing structure of proteins. Before knowing about the proteins, first we have to know the peptide. Yes, If you see two molecules here, one is the CH2 NH2 COOH. Left side is having NH2 group, right side is having COOH. The central carbon is having two same type of hydrogen atoms. What is the name of this compound? What is the name of this amino acid? Glycine. Once again, remember, NH2 single bond, CH2 single bond, COOH is known as glycine. And NH2 single bond CH, here in this CH2, if one hydrogen is substituted, here you can see now, one hydrogen is substituted with CH3 group, then we are going to get the derivative form of glycine. Now it is called as alanine. So here we are taking two amino acids. One is the glycine, second one is the alanine. When they are going to condense with each other, during the condensation process, what is going to happen? Formation of a large molecule by the elimination of small molecule. From the carboxylic acid, this carboxylic acid, glycine containing carboxylic acid group, this OH group is going to react with hydrogen of amine group in the alanine. This is the hydrogen of alanine. So what will be removed? Water molecule will be removed to form a large molecule. This reaction is an example of condensation reaction. Now, between the glycine, this is the glycine, between the glycine and alanine, here you can see the bond formation. This is the special bond formation. So what is the bond here? Single bond CO, single bond NH. So this bond between the two amino acids, CO-NH bond between the two amino acids. Once again, CO-NH bond between the two amino acids is called as peptide linkage. Yes, on the board I am going to write. No need to worry. So formation of peptide linkages. How we will get a peptide linkage? So if you know the formation of peptide linkages, then we can understand the formation of proteins. So proteins are formed from alpha amino acids. Alpha amino acids are having capital L configuration, right? So I'm taking the two compounds. One is the glycine. What is the structure of glycine? NH2, single bond CH2, single bond C, double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. Yes, my dear students, you have to remember, here this is the carbon having two same type of hydrogen atoms. So this carbon is called as achiral carbon or symmetrical carbon. This is the carbon known as achiral carbon. So whenever the compound is having achiral carbon, in general they are optically inactive. So we can understand that glycine is an example of optically inactive compound. Glycine is the optically inactive compound. When it is going to condense with alanine, yes, the structure of alanine is NH2 on the left side, CH. Here it is CH2. Here one hydrogen is substituted. Now CH, the hydrogen substituted with CH3 group. Remaining is same as is. Single bond, C double bond O, single bond O, single bond H. Now it is known as alanine. Now my dear students, tell me, if you observe this carbon, here I'm going to indicate the star. Why I'm going to indicate the star? Because it is carbon containing four different types of groups. What are the four different types of groups? Single bond NH2 group is there at this carbon. Single bond hydrogen is there. Single bond CH3 is there. And single bond COOH group is there. So this is the carbon which is indicated with asterisk. According to computers, it is called as asterisk. Or according to the general mathematics, it is known as star. So a starred carbon indicating it is a chiral carbon. Chiral carbon. This is a carbon known as chiral carbon. Or this is a carbon known as asymmetric carbon. Chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. So this compound is optically active. Optically active. So first compound is optically inactive amino acid. Second compound is optically active amino acid. Now, these two are going to react with each other and removal of OH group from glycine and removal of hydrogen from alanine, then removal of water molecule. Condensation reaction is going to happen. So here is the reaction. This is an example of condensation reaction. Then we will get a linkage between glycine and alanine. that linkage going to be formed between glycine and alanine, that is called as peptide linkage. Now we can write this one as NH2 single bond CH2 single bond C double bond O single bond C double bond O single bond. Here it is NH group, nitrogen single bond, hydrogen single bond. Yes, this is the group, or this is the linkage called as peptide linkage. Single bond C double bond O single bond NH single bond. This linkage is called as peptide linkage. Okay, and remaining, what is remaining here after NH? What is the remaining? Single bond CH3. Okay, single bond COOH. So this is the compound known as a polymer, and it is containing a peptide linkage. What is the group present in the peptide linkage? Means single bond C double bond O single bond NH single bond. Now this formed compound is called as glyala. Why we are saying glyala? Because it is obtained from glycine and alanine, hence it is known as glyala. Glyala is containing how many peptide linkages? Glyala is containing how many peptide linkages? One peptide linkage. If any compound is having one peptide linkage, that is called as a dipeptide. So glyala, it is an example of glyala. This is an example of dipeptide. Yes. Now tell me, dipeptides contain how many peptide linkages? This is only one peptide linkage. Why we are saying it is a dipeptide? Because it is obtained from two amino acids. Once again, when the dipeptide is taken, the dipeptide is going to come from two amino acids. Hence, it is called as a dipeptide. But the dipeptide is going to contain only one peptide linkage. Very, very, very important concept. So the dipeptides are going to contain one peptide linkage. Please try to understand. So once again, the dipeptides are going to contain one peptide linkage. Like that, tripeptides contain two peptide linkages. Tetrapeptides contain three peptide linkages. Once again, the dipeptides are going to contain one peptide linkage. Tripeptides contain two peptide linkages. Tetrapeptides contain three peptide linkages. Now, coming to the question, given question. What is the question given here? What is the question number? Question number 7. On the screen, you can see the question number 7. Yes, once again, read the question. The number of peptide bonds present in tetrapeptide is. The number of peptide bonds present in tetrapeptide is. Yes, three peptide bonds are going to be present. What is the question number? Question number 7. Yes, question number 7. Yes, question number 7. Option number 3. Volume 4. Page number 120. Objective exercise 2. Question number 7. Option is 3. So try tetrapeptides. Tetrapeptides contain three peptide linkages. I'm going to share this PDF. Please read this PDF. You can understand easily. A dipeptide contain one peptide linkage. A tripeptide contain two peptide linkages. A tetrapeptide contain three peptide linkages or three peptide bonds. Yes, this is the same structure, whatever already I explained on the board. Glyala. Instead of calling as glyala, we can also call it as glycolalanine, or simply we can call it as glyala. If you observe this glyala, how many letters are there for glycine? Three letters are there for glycine. To represent the glycine, we are using three letters, and to represent the alanine, we are using three letters. So simply we can understand that to represent the alpha amino acids, we are using three letter symbol. So to represent the glycine, we are using GLY. To represent the alanine, we are using ALA. So gly is indicating glycine, ALA is indicating alanine. And glycine is an example of optically inactive alpha amino acid. Alanine is an example of optically active alpha amino acid. But both glycine and alanine, they are going to be produced within the body of the humans. Once again, the glycine and alanine, they are going to be produced in the human body itself. There is no need of taking these amino acids through the diet. There is no need of these amino acids taking through the diet. So whatever the amino acids which can be produced by the body itself and there is no need to take through the diet, such amino acids are called as non-essential amino acids. Non-essential amino acids. Yes, I'm going to share the textbook to you. Essential amino acids and non-essential amino acids. Classification of amino acids. Classification of amino acids. Yes, from your NCERT class 12 chemistry textbook, year 2020, you are seeing the natural structure of amino acid, natural representation of amino acid, or general representation of amino acid. So this is the general representation of amino acid. Here you have to remember only the R group, right? So here in the compound, if the R group is hydrogen, if the residual group is hydrogen, then it is known as glycine. The three letter symbol for glycine is GLY and the one letter symbol for glycine is G. And if the residual group is replaced or substituted with CH3 group, then the compound obtained is called as alanine. And the three letter symbol for alanine is ALA, ALA. One letter symbol for glycine, alanine is A. If you observe the glycine and alanine, no star is given. In the textbook, no star is given. If star is not given, means they are going to be produced by the body itself. There is no need to take through the diet. So whatever the amino acids, there is no need to take through the diet. They are called as non-essential amino acids. So glycine and alanine are the examples of non-essential amino acids. I'm coming to the board to give you some more clarity about glycine and alanine. About glycine and alanine, we are going to know some more points. Can you guess whether glycine is optically active or optically inactive amino acid? Glycine and alanine. Yes, both are having a similarity. What is the similarity? Means simply by taking a cross. At the top, I am going to take COOH group. At the left side, I am going to take NH2 group. And at the bottom, I am going to take hydrogen atom. So in both glycine and alanine, both are having the same groups at the three ends. But at the fourth end, here is the hydrogen atom is present. Whereas here at the fourth end, CH3 group is present. So this is the main difference between glycine and alanine. And one more thing, if you observe the carbon, the tetravalent carbon, if you observe this tetravalent carbon, it is having two same type of groups, this hydrogen and this hydrogen. So this carbon is having two same type of groups. Two same type of groups are present. Hence, this carbon is called as a chiral carbon. Very, very, very important topic. A chiral carbon. Hence, this compound is optically inactive. Glycine is an example of optically inactive compound. And glycine is produced by the body itself. In the human body itself, the glycine is going to be produced. So there is no need to take through the diet. Hence, glycine is an example of non-essential amino acid. So this is all about information regarding glycine. Now coming to alanine. In the alanine, here you can see the carbon. This carbon is having four different groups. Now we can say that this carbon is which type of carbon? Chiral carbon or also known as asymmetric carbon, chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon, chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon. Hence, this compound alanine is optically active. Optically active alpha amino acid. And one more thing, this alanine can also be produced by the human body itself. There is no need to take through the diet. Hence, alanine is an example of non-essential amino acid. So this is a complete description and information regarding glycine and alanine. Now tell me, what is the similarity between glycine and alanine? Glycine and alanine, both are the alpha amino acids. Both are the examples of alpha amino acids. This is the first similarity. And the second similarity is, both are the examples of non-essential amino acids. But what is the difference between glycine and alanine means? Glycine is going to contain a chiral carbon, that is optically inactive compound, whereas alanine is going to contain optically active carbon, or that is asymmetric carbon. Hence, alanine is going to be optically active. So in simple, we can say that glycine is optically inactive alpha amino acid, alanine is optically active alpha amino acid. So this is a major difference between glycine and alanine. To represent in a three-letter symbol, glycine is represented as GLY, whereas alanine is represented as ALA, three-letter symbol. If it is for one-letter symbol, then we can write capital A indicating the alanine and capital G is indicating glycine. So this is about alanine and glycine, or glycine and alanine. So once again, I'm going to check the question number 7. Okay, 7 is completed already, right? Now, see the question number 8. Read the question number 8. Which one of the following statement is incorrect? Which one of the following statement is incorrect regarding stereochemistry of the most of the amino acids? Which one of the following statement is incorrect regarding stereochemistry of the most of the amino acids? Yes, all of you know that amino acids, that is alpha amino acids, are having capital L configuration, but not capital R configuration. Most of the alpha amino acids are having capital L configuration, but not capital R configuration. Sorry, right. Wait a minute. Yes, once check the options. What are the options given? First option, amino acid containing 3 carbon atoms. Amino acid containing 3 carbon atoms is optically active. They have L configuration. Yes, all amino acids are having L configuration, right? They have R configuration. Glycine is optically inactive. Yes, just now we discussed that glycine is optically inactive. We know amino acid containing 3 carbon atoms. So for this one, we have to see the textbook. Yes, I am opening the textbook to you. Once see the general representation of alpha amino acids. General representation. This is the general representation of alpha amino acid. Once see this one. Yes. So here, instead of R, if you take any of these groups, characteristic feature of side chain capital R, simply residual group. So instead of R, we can take hydrogen or methyl group or isopropyl group or isobutyl group. We can take any of these groups. Of course, here also so many groups are there. Once check this list of alpha amino acids. Some amino acids given with stars, they are indicating essential amino acids. That means they are not produced by the body itself. The amino acids which are indicated by the star, they are not produced by the body itself. They must be taken through the diet. Such amino acids are called as essential amino acids. So here, already we know that alpha amino acids, most of the alpha amino acids are having L configuration, but not R configuration. So option is 3. For the question number 8, option is 3. So in this session, we are discussing only the topic alpha amino acids. We are discussing only amino acids as well as proteins. So that's why I'm discussing only the MCQs regarding amino acids and proteins. So then, in your material, page number 121, volume 4, next question number is, question number 11. See the question number 11. Question number 11. Yes, on the screen you can see now the question number 11. Yes, read the question number 11. How many tripeptides can be prepared by linking the amino acids glycine, alanine and phenylalanine? Yes, once again the question. How many tripeptides can be prepared by linking the amino acids glycine, alanine and phenylalanine? My dear students, to understand this question and to answer this question, just you can simply apply your logical brain. Just simply apply your logical brain. How many tripeptides can be obtained, can be prepared by linking the three amino acids? What are the three amino acids given? First amino acid is glycine. Second amino acid is alanine. Third amino acid is phenylalanine. So by using these three, by linking with different groups, how many tripeptides we are going to get? First of all, why they are said to be as tripeptides means, when these three are going to be linked with each other, the molecule formed is going to be said to be as a tripeptide. So very simple topic it is. Three amino acids are given. One is glycine. Second one is alanine. Third one is phenylalanine. How many tripeptides we will get by using different linkages? How many tripeptides we will get from the three amino acids given? What are the three amino acids given? Glycine, alanine, and phenylalanine. Glycine, alanine, and phenylalanine are the three amino acids given. So when three amino acids are going to be linked with each other to form a peptide, what is the peptide going to be obtained? Called as tripeptide. Because when three amino acids are going to be reacted to give a condensation polymer, then the obtained condensation polymer is called as a tripeptide. Tripeptide is going to contain how many peptide linkages? Yes, tripeptide is going to contain two peptide linkages. Anyhow, suppose I am going to take glycine as 1, alanine as 2, and phenylalanine as 3. 1, 2, 3. Just neglect the names glycine, alanine, and phenylalanine. Just simply remember them as 1, 2, 3. Yes, according to mathematics, you know the probability. If the numbers given 1, 2, 3 are there, how many times we can arrange these numbers to get different values? To get different values by arranging these numbers, how many times we can arrange to get the different values? So this is according to the concept of probability from the mathematics. How many numbers are given here? Three different numbers are given. Not the same type of numbers are given. Three different types of numbers are given. 1, 2, 3 is given. They are the three different numbers. So how many times we can arrange to get a different value? By using all the three numbers, how many times we can arrange to get a different value means 3 factorial. All of you know the factorial, 3 factorial. The math students can understand this one, probability. 3 factorial is written as 3 into 2 into 1. That is equal to 6. So the 3 factorial, you know, 2 factorial, 3 factorial, 4 factorial and so on. So the 3 factorial is equal to 3 into 2 into 1, that is equal to 6. So 1, 2, 3 can be arranged in 6 different manners. Once again, 1, 2, 3 can be arranged in 3 different manners to get a different values. How can we arrange this one? Let's say this one. 1, 2, 3. 1, 3, 2. Two different arrangements. 2, 1, 3. 2-3-1. Again, two different arrangements. Next, 3-1-2, 3-2-1. Again, two different arrangements. So how many different arrangements with different values by using the three different numbers is possible means 3 factorial. This is the one value, 123, 132, 213, 231, 312, 321. So how many values are obtained? 6 values are obtained. Suppose if 1 is taken as glycine, 2 is taken as alanine, 3 is taken as a phenyl alanine. Now here we are going to get 1 tripeptide, 2nd tripeptide, 3rd tripeptide, 4th tripeptide, 5th tripeptide, and 6th tripeptide. So for your easiness, I am writing like this by using mathematics. That is the probability. Concept is probability. So anyhow, the question number 11. Very, very, very important concept. It is question number 11. Once again, the same question. Question number 11. How many tripeptides can be prepared by linking the amino acids glycine, alanine, and phenyl alanine? Yes, glycine is taken as 1, alanine is taken as 2, phenyl alanine is taken as 3. So the number of possible arrangements is, or the number of possible arrangements are, 6 possible arrangements are there. Then we can say that 6 different types of polypeptides can we get by using different linkages between alanine, phenyl alanine, and glycine, right? So to avoid the length of the video, I'm going to stop this session. Remaining MCQs we will discuss in the next video lectures. But the thing is, just I'm teaching from my side, whether you are watching or not, I don't know. Only very few students are responding. What about the remaining? At the final day, you are going to be the sufferer. If you are not going to watch the videos, if you are not going to practice, if you are not going to ask or clarify your doubts, at the final day, you are going to be the sufferer. So please don't do like that. Practice every day, at least for 1 hour. Practice every subject for 1 hour, every day. Because now we are coming at the end of this year. Within 2 days, the new year is going to be started. January is going to come. Later, all of you know, February, March, April. Very soon, you have to face the examination, that is PU as well as JEE, NEET, and KSET. So don't waste time. Don't neglect. Practice every day. If you are having the doubts, you can call me on my WhatsApp number, 94902-83667. This is your chemistry lecturer, Sajjan Naidu, signing off. Have a nice day.